बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू विल बी फाइन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट यूनिट 5, फिजिकल स्टेट ऑफ मैटर्स। व्हाट इज़ मैटर? एवरीथिंग इन द यूनिवर्स इज मेड अप ऑफ मैटर एंड इट हैज़ 3 टाइप्स, सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैसेस। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट 3 स्टेट्स, गैसियस, लिक्विड एंड सॉलिड स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर एंड देयर लॉज। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस जनरल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैसेस, एंड द फर्स्ट हेडिंग इज इंट्रोडक्शन एंड सब हेडिंग इज फिजिकल स्टेट्स। मैटर एग्जिस्ट इन 3 फिजिकल स्टेट्स, फर्स्ट स्टेट गैस, सेकेंड लिक्विड एंड थर्ड सॉलिड। देन हेडिंग इज gaseous state. The simplest form of matter is the gaseous state. Liquids are the less common and most of the matter exists as solid. We know that most of the elements in the periodic table consist of matters which are solid and rest of some are liquids and rest of them are gases. And next heading is properties of gases. Matter in gaseous state does not have definite shape and volume. Properties of matter in gaseous state or properties of matter in gaseous state is the next heading, which is starting from here. Matter in gaseous state does not have definite shape and volume. Therefore, gases occupy all the available space. Their intermolecular forces are very weak. Pressure is a significant property of gases. Listen girls, we know that gaseous molecules have high kinetic energy, that's why they move very rapidly and spread from one place to another place very quickly due to other random motion and due to the high kinetic energy of their molecules. So we also know that they don't have definite shape and volume because they are in the gaseous form and they move randomly and take the shape of the container in which we put it. Their intermolecular forces are very weak and pressure is a significant property of the gases. The effect of pressure and temperature on volume of a gas has been studied quite extensively. What is the effect of pressure and what is the effect of pressure and temperature on volume of a gas? For example, if we increase the pressure or temperature, then the volume of gas will expand or will decrease or increase have been studied extensively and we will discuss later in this chapter. Next, the liquid state. Properties of matter in liquid state. The liquid state has strong intermolecular forces, hence it has definite volume but does not have definite shape. It maintains the shape of the container in which it is kept. Liquids evaporate and their vapors exert pressure. When pressure of a liquid becomes equal to external pressure, it boils. What is the boiling point? You can mark here. When pressure of a liquid becomes equal to the external pressure, it boils. For example, when we heat the liquid, the kinetic energy of the liquid molecules will increase, which will increase the pressure inside the liquid molecule. And when the pressure inside the liquid molecules increases and become equal to the atmospheric pressure. What is atmospheric pressure? The pressure of air in the atmosphere. And it will become equal to the atmospheric pressure. It boils. Liquids are less mobile than gases, therefore they diffuse slowly. The diffusion rate of gases is more because they have high kinetic energy than the solids, because the solids have less kinetic energy. Solid molecules have less kinetic energy, that's why they diffuse slowly than gases. And next heading is solid state. The solid state has definite volume and shape. We know that because there are strong molecular forces exist in solid state and they don't move, rather than they vibrate on their positions That's why they have definite shape and volume. They are rigid and dense than liquid and gas. They have more density than the liquid and gas because they have heavy masses. They exist in the amorphous or crystalline form. Amorphous mean powder form or crystalline form or crystals in the form of crystals. So next, after the introduction, the first physical property, we will discuss about the physical property of gases, and the first physical property of gases is diffusion. We know that we have already discussed about diffusion in liquid molecules, from the in which liquid molecules move from higher concentration to lower concentration. But the diffusion in gases is somewhat different. It is the spontaneous intermixing mixing of molecules of one gas with another at a given temperature and pressure is called diffusion. In the diffusion of gases, we will discuss about the diffusion and mixing of one gas with another gas at given temperature and pressure. It is the random movement of molecules of gas from an area of higher concentration to the area of low concentration. For example, we have two gases and one gas has a higher concentration than the other gas, and these two gases will intermix with each other randomly and intermix with each other randomly, and this is called diffusion. You can see in this diagram, diffusion is the spontaneous intermixing of molecules from the higher concentration to the lower concentration, and in this diagram molecules are mixing with each other. From gas 1 is mixing with gas 2 and gas 2 is mixing with gas 1. And the second property of gases is effusion. Effusion means the molecules move from higher concentration to the lower concentration and to the other part of the container through a hole, and the other part will be evacuated or empty. So the gas molecules will move through a hole from one part to another part, and this is called effusion, in which gas molecules move from one side to another empty side. But in diffusion, gas 1 and gas 2 molecules will intermix with each other randomly. Next, typical properties. Gases have similar physical properties. A few typical properties are discussed here. Diffusion, first of all, definition of diffusion. Gases can diffuse very rapidly. Diffusion is defined as spontaneous mixing up of molecules by random motion and collision to form a homogeneous mixture. This means spontaneously two gases will mix with each other by random motion and collisions. कुलियंस मीन एक दूसरे के साथ टकराना, एक दूसरे के साथ एक दूसरे से कंबाइन करना, टू फॉर्म अ होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर. होमोजीनियस मीन सेम मिक्सचर अंटिल दे बिकम होमोजीनियस. गैस वन एंड गैस टू विल इंटरमिक्स विद ईच अदर बाय रैंडम मोशन एंड कुलियन अंटिल दे फॉर्म होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर, एंड दिस इज द डिफ्यूजन इन गैसेज. एंड नेक्स्ट हेडिंग इज rate of diffusion dependence. Rate of diffusion depends upon the molecular mass of the gases. Lighter gases diffuse rapidly than heavier ones. And for example, next heading is example, hydrogen diffuses 4 times faster than oxygen gas. And the second is effusion. It is escaping of gas molecules through a tiny hole into a space with less pressure. For example, when a tire gets punctured, air effuses out. First line is, it is escaping of gas molecules till pressure is the definition, and next is example. And next, dependence. Effusion depends upon molecular masses. Lighter gases effuse faster than heavier gases. And next, pressure. Gas molecules are always in continuous state of motion. We know that. Hence, when molecules strike with the walls of the container or any other surface, they exert pressure. Pressure is defined as a force exerted by per unit surface area. P is equal to pressure is equal to force over per unit area. द सिस्टम इंटरनेशनल यूनिट ऑफ फोर्स इज न्यूटन एंड दैट्स द एरिया एंड दैट ऑफ एरिया इज मीटर स्क्वेयर हिज प्रेशर हैज सिस्टम इंटरनेशनल यूनिट ऑफ न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वेयर इट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड पास्कल और वन पास्कल इज इक्वल टू वन न्यूटन मीटर पर स्क्वेयर फॉर दिस मीन when the gas molecules in the container exert pressure on the surface of in the areas of container of about meter square then the pressure exerted by the gas molecules that surface area of a container is called a force which is represented by which is represented by the unit Newton and Newton is equal to 1 Pascal or 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton meter per square. Barometer is used to measure the atmospheric pressure and the nanometer is used to measure the pressure in the laboratory. Atmospheric pressure, the pressure in the air we can measure by using barometer is the instrument and if we want to measure the pressure in lab then we have another device which is called manometer is used to measure the pressure in the laboratory for practical convenience so this is our today's lecture you have to learn these definitions diffusion effusion and pressure And in the introduction, we have to learn properties of solid, liquid, and gases. Till then, Allah Hafiz. And next, we will discuss about other typical properties of gases. Till then, Allah Hafiz. Have a good day.